I blocked the sky area. I didn't use many colors, just I used yellow, yellow ochre, purple, and a little bit white. I used these three colors to block the sky, or roughly I put the colors what I am visualizing in my mind. Next I will go for this area which is near to the sky. After I painted this area, I'm thinking what I have to do with this area, because when you're painting from imagination, you face this problem. You have to think, you have to evolve moment to moment. There won't be any pre-planning. You have to plan whatever things happening on the canvas. Based on that, you have to improve your visual imagination. I will try something when you see it from the distance, somehow it looking nice, it looking appealing. So this is the basic planning of the painting from imagination. Now I have to go to second step. What it would be? I have to think about it. Sometimes I may get easily. Sometimes it's becoming very tough, lot of struggle. It's all purely, or at least sometimes, depends upon your chances, believe me. Okay, I'll try what's going to be next. I am thinking I don't need to work anymore this type art. I dislike to work applying so much paint on any area. If I am able to finish with little paints, with little brush strokes, I will enjoy. I will stop it. Now I think the sky is over. So then I will go for next part. What is going to happen? I used this yellow stroke, a diagonal stroke, to balance this picture. See now here, this color and this color and this color. All these things will connect with each other. It helps to achieve balance in the picture. Again, I am telling, it helps to achieve balance in the picture. This balance leads to harmony and unity. These three things are very important to any successful painting. Once again, I am telling, balance leads to harmony and unity. No need to work too much. All you have to put right color in right places. Right color means exact tonal value in color. Exact tonal value in color, you have to put it in right place. It will do its job. It leads to successful painting. Putting so much color, mixing and merging so many values won't do any good. It's always economy. Economy. Put as less color as possible. Where you have to put thick color, put it more. Where you have to use thin color, use little color. But overall, it requires understanding. What you are painting, that you have to understand. What you want to achieve, that you have to understand. What you are applying there, that you have to think so many times. When you are painting, your mind has to think continuously without any rest. It has to be always in alert. More or less, this area is finished. Now I have to think what I have to do here. I am always not interested to so much of work. Again, I am telling. So I will try to finish it in a very less work. Before going bottom of the painting a little bit, I think a little bit touch is required. A little bit light is required here to flow that light. Maybe a little bit. But is it necessary or not? I have to think a moment, a minute. Yeah, it's good. It applied well, it's good. Because now that mountain slope, the edge you are seeing clearly, it is giving structure to the painting. Otherwise, totally is too hazy. Because of this light, the sharpness, this sharp edges here is showing the mountain structure. So, the viewer feels totally realistic illusion, even though it painted in an abstract way. So to make it realistic feeling, to give realistic illusion to the viewer, even though you paint in an abstract way, here and there, you have to clear the structures. Then only he feels It's a realistic painting. If you work it everything clear, he feels it is somehow artificial because you won't see the nature that way. If you make everything diffused in painting, then also he feels something it is artificial. So you have to know where to have to sharpen, where to have give. You have to know where you have to give hard edges, where you have to give soft edges, where you have to give blurred edges. These are important in a painting. Again, I am telling, there are three edges: hard edges, soft edges, blurred edges. These three edges will play key role in any painting. So you have to understand them, you have to study them, you have to come to the clarity where you have to apply them. That's very, very important subject you have to learn, edges, not this point. Now I'm going to work the bottom of the canvas. I told you already, I'm not going to work much, maybe I'll finish it quickly. I got a visual idea about how I paint some water here, because this pot will connect with this pot. For that, I decide to paint here some water. I don't need to paint so much of water all this area. A little bit of that color you call it. That light, the color, the white, if it reflects here, this pot and this pot will connect with each other. So the painting then looks as a whole. It won't be bits and pieces. this area is finished. I'm not going to work anymore there. All I need is a visual feeling of the scene. When the viewer sees this, he feels that water, the grass, the dusty or rough ground, pebbles, small stones, small bushes, thorn, everything he feels. What more we want actually, we don't need any more. All you have to make him feel that reality of that area. When you achieve it, it's a simple work. Why you have to work more and more and more? Honesty. Our mind, our thinking system tuned. If we want a good painting, you have to work more. Once again, I am telling, our thinking system tuned. If we want create a good painting, we have to work a lot. That's a wrong notion. All we have to work whatever is necessary. You don't need to work anymore. You don't need to work any less. Just work what is required. For that, you need to think a lot. This is the key. Now I want to say. Here, I painted this color to balance that sky area, that purple area, the purple color in the sky has to reflect here and there in the foreground or middle ground. In this foreground, I applied the same purple to balance the picture. And here, I am not working much. I didn't work much because give it to the viewer's imagination. That's always better. Now I will work this area. I have come to the conclusion it requires two trees, thin trees, not much thick, because this whole picture requires verticals. These are all horizontals, diagonals. So it requires to get that unified balance, few verticals. Now I will draw two trees without disturbing the simplicity of the picture. After drawing these two trees, I'm feeling a third one may be required in this space to balance this area. It's good, but I will give some suggestions of some small few trees, just only suggestions, not much detail, leaving that Now I need here also to balance those trees. Let me see. Yeah, it's good. I may draw to give a suggestion of That's good. Now you are filling the total that area. Yeah, we don't need any more, just is enough. We'll give some branches, position of branches, leaving them simply as verticals. I don't like H, so I will add few verticals. Yeah, it's good. Nothing is showing separately or distinctly or significantly. They are all part of the I'm not going to give much branches. I think the picture is over. I don't need to work anymore. It is simple and effective, and it will give lot of scope to the viewer to imagine the area. That is what an artist has to do in his final step. He has to give the scope to the viewer to imagine what the things are existing in the painting. I think I have done that job reasonably. So once again I will look a little bit from the distance this painting. I think the painting is over. It doesn't need any more work. I will sign the painting now. Yeah, with this sign, the painting is over. Now, I will show this painting in close-up. You have seen close-up shots of the painting. You have seen how I applied my brush and knife on canvas with broad strokes, not any color mixing, just I simply leave them without matching the colors. And I painted everything suggestively. I didn't try to work to show the detail. Detail will come automatically if you work what it requires. So all you have to do to get detail, you have to know what to work, what to paint, and finally how you have to visualize the whole scene. How you have to visualize the whole scene, that's the key. And you have to balance each and everything on canvas as a whole. This color has to connect to this color. These purples here and there, I left them because they will connect touch. And here also you see the purples, they connected. And the greens and yellows, everywhere they are. Everywhere they are. This painting totally finished in broader terms, yellow and violet scheme. I used very little colors, yellow, a little bit, slightly here and there, slightly orange, slightly. And the purples and violets, a slight, a touch of blue, white. That's all. I didn't work, I didn't use many colors also. And I tried to finish the painting as simple as possible. That is the key. I tried to finish the painting as simple as possible without much doing overwork. That's the key. And I think I finished this painting within an hour, more or less, approximately. The size of the painting is 60 into 48 inches, 5 into 4 feet. This much large size I finished in roughly 1 hour. How it happened? Because I simplified my work. I simplified my work to basics. What it requires to create the feeling, visual feeling in the viewer about this landscape. He has to feel the depth, the distance, the color, and he has to enjoy it. For that, what I have to work, how much I have to work. This is the taste. This taste every artist requires. This taste will come to you through knowledge. This taste will come to you through knowledge. That's the key. Thank you.